Hello, people. Welcome to today's live. I'm going to change this just a little bit. There we go. Okay, so I hope you guys can hear me okay. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Carly. I am here to talk to you guys today as the fourth part of our four-part series on revitalizing through vitamins. So I wanted to talk a little bit about how we can sort of strengthen our immune systems and build immunity in these times, and in any time in general. It's very important, but especially now people are worried. And one thing we always have to understand is that whatever comes within us, whatever we ingest, or whatever gets inside of us as a pathogen, you have to understand that it's our immune system that takes care of it or not. So it's always good to tie your camel, as people say, and do what you can in order to prevent your immunity from becoming weakened. So I'd like to talk a little bit today about supplements. It's not something that I encourage people to do in an abundant fashion. However, I can definitely stress some things that we should be aware of and take into consideration. So there's a couple of things: immune boosters versus immune builders. Immune builders basically build and support our already naturally occurring immune system. Immune boosters give whatever we have going right now an extra boost. So we have things that build it up, and then we have things that boost it. If you have an immune compromised illness, disease, then you should not be taking immune boosters. Rather, just stick with immune builders. That's a big thing. And I will tell you the difference between each one. So the first thing with regards to immune builders, this is what I want everybody to think about and to start with, especially those with immunocompromised systems. Vitamin A, C, E, zinc, selenium, all of these vitamins and minerals are not only antioxidants, but they're very much immune builders, and vitamin D as well. We need to make sure that we are getting ample, adequate and ample amounts of these during the flu season in general, and especially now. The winter months, where we are not getting as much vitamin D, where viruses and flus seem to be a lot more rampant, we need to make sure that we are accumulating them. And sometimes, just as like an insurance policy, it's not a bad idea to take a vitamin C supplement. So I highly recommend that we make sure that we're focused on immune building. Another thing that I highly recommend are probiotics. These are the friendly bacteria that colonize our system from our mouth all the way down through to the very end of our digestive system, which I'm sure you know what that is. And these are protective microflora that protect us from pathogenic influences in the body. Okay, so along with A, C, E, D, zinc, selenium as antioxidants and immune builders, probiotics, and the other one I'm going to say as an anti-inflammatory would be essential fatty acids. So your omega-3s specifically, okay? They keep the inflammation down, but they keep the immune system responses in check, okay? So if you are going to think about consuming these other than food sources, just because you're not sure if you're getting enough, then I highly highly recommend that you get, like, they have a supplement called ACEs. It's ACE and selenium. It's a great antioxidant, or you could just take a vitamin C. I wanted to emphasize vitamin C. It strengthens the immune system in 20 different ways. So for those, I know there's a lot of controversial information out there. A lot of doctors are saying there's absolutely no evidence whatsoever that vitamin C helps, you know, fight COVID-19. Well, maybe not directly, no, because they haven't had time to do studies on it. But the amount of research and science that has proven that vitamin C has a direct effect on the immune system and interferons, on phagocytes and specific white blood cells that fight disease and illness is there. You can look it up anywhere you want, but it's definitely there. It helps in the generation and production of our white blood cells, and our white blood cells are what fight this off. That's all there is to it. Our bodies have to fight whatever comes into contact off. That's just how it goes. I wanted to talk about vitamin C, and in terms of, okay, if you're not getting it through a supplement, which I do recommend people taking in a supplement if you're going to take one, then the most rich food sources, okay? So, kiwis, right? They actually have a lot more than oranges do. Lemons, acerola cherries are another really big one. Guavas, chili peppers, Brussels sprouts. Yellow peppers, yellow peppers have the most out of the three colors, or the four colors. Parsley, thyme, black currants. I said Brussels sprouts, black currants, broccoli, strawberries, all these are super rich in vitamin C. So make sure that you're getting a lot of these different foods in your diet. Of course, most of them are fruits and vegetables, also kale and spinach, really good source of vitamin C, which they're also a good source of other things as well. So you definitely want to make sure that you're getting those into your system. I wanted to talk a little bit about immune, herbs for immunity, okay, which are super important. A lot of you guys are aware of immune builders like echinacea. It is an immune booster though. So if you are immunocompromised, please don't worry about echinacea. That is something that if you're healthy, you can definitely have with the onset of any flu or virus, cold, cough symptoms. It actually helps your body. It stimulates your body's natural production of white blood cells. So that's how it works. That's why people use it. That's why people let everybody else know that it's helped them minimize the effects of their infection. Sometimes it can keep it at bay almost completely, depending on it. Another herb for immunity is astragalus. It's an anti-inflammatory. It's also an antibacterial. Okay. Other ones that are very common in our household are ginger, garlic, and honey. Okay, these all have antibacterial properties and they keep your immune system strong. You would want to make sure that you can have them in all different, you can have them in tea fashion with warm water. You can do a lemon, ginger, honey tea. You can make it from your own lemon, ginger, and honey at home. You don't have to buy it already in a packet. It's better if it's fresh. And just make sure are wise with your health. The other big thing that I need to suggest is that, guys, one of the things that suppresses our immune system without any question is sugar, or anything that metabolizes into sugar. So white flour, white bread, anything white that you're consuming, it breaks down as sugar in our bodies. So sugar suppresses our immune systems. So you need to make sure that you are not over consuming sugar. Okay. It's super, super important. Yeah. Good. I'm glad it's your favorite. It's tasty. Lemon, ginger, honey tea, super tasty, but it's a really, really, really good. good habit to get into having that, especially for the throat and the immune system in general. So where was I? The other thing that I wanted to also suggest was, where do you get your vitamins and how? I am not an endorser or any type of agent like that for Healthy Planet. However, because I have been a customer of theirs for so long, I have been able to witness the type of products they carry, their competitive pricing, really good staff, and they have online shopping. So if you're ever interested in getting probiotic, or if you're interested in hang on, somebody's in my back, not in my backyard, another backyard. But if you're ever interested, you can go on to Healthy Planet. Go on to Healthy Planet and see what they have online, and you can order and have it mailed, so you don't have to go to a store. Anyways, I'm going to leave now. I'm not sure how much is going on. Please put your questions in the comments, and I'll be glad to answer them. Okay, ladies, it was nice. I'm going to share this live, so don't worry. If you missed any of it, you can go back and take it. Take care. Bye-bye.